Sir, what is autism? Why this disease is so important?
Actually, autism is a behavioral disorder which is caused in children, mainly in the age from 2.5 years of age to 9 to 10 years of age. Actually speaking, the disorder is mainly of genetic type, and it can be, or it may be started even before itself. But we can elicit the disease, or we can detect the disease only in the age of 2.5 years. Why this disease is important? That's the main question. So almost everybody knows what is autism and how it affects the child, etc. What is important is, usually in other diseases, only diseased person will be affected, or he will be having difficulty in living. But in the case of autism, the diseased person or the child, as well as the parent, either father or mother or both, will be suffering for lifelong. And the tremendous thing that we can see is the prevalence of autistic children in India. Now it's almost 10 million children is affected with autism. And in 10 years before time, there was a prevalence of disease only in 10,000, 1 out of 10,000 children. But it has come to almost 1 children or 1 child in every 66 child. The expectation in 2017, there was a study in 2000, and they were expecting that in 2017 to 2020, there will be a prevalence of autism is 1 in 150. So it crossed the more than double of that. In the sense, 1 child in every 66 children is affected with autism. So we can see that the tremendous change or tremendous increase in the size of autistic children in India is, we can't say the number also. Like that, it is going far away without having any remedy in our science. So it has to be corrected, otherwise the whole life or whole life of the children or child, as well as a parent, is spoiling without any usage. That's very lost to the nation also.
Sir, actually, what is the cause of this disease? How it diagnosed?
Actually, in the modern science, it is said that the cause is unknown. Means, we don't know the cause, why it happens. Unless and until we don't know the root cause of the disease, it's very difficult to treat. The basic line of treatment is we should remove the root cause. In Ayurveda, it says we have to treat the cause first. Then only root level treatment, or it can be taken from the root level. But in Ayurveda, it says that all these disorders, usually autism and other disorders like autism, is named under autism spectrum disorders. So ASD. So these type of disorders in Ayurveda, it is specifically meant in Unmada Chigilsa. There is a chapter called Unmada. All these disorders are merely said under Unmada Chigilsa. And the main cause of that Unmada, whatever Ayurvedic term we use, that Unmada term or Unmada disease, the cause of that is mainly by Matra, means mother's Ahara and Vihara, that is diet and regimen. So during the time of pregnancy, or before even conceiving also, how the mother's mind will be, how the mother's mind, mother's food, mother's regimen, daily routine, all these things will be affecting the child. And nowadays, very pathetic to say that we are getting our newborns as accident. Literally, we say that it is an accident, because conceiving is an accident, and taking care of the child in the womb, that's also, it's like we are not having any time to take care of the child. So all these things will be affecting the child, and other factors even after birth. Proper taking care of the child, proper taking care of the mother after birth also will result in this. And how we can diagnose? Diagnose in the sense, as I told, only in the age of 2.5 years the child will express his views, express towards the external stimuli, etc. So when we, when he or she expresses attitude or say something, only we can diagnose the disease. Even maximum of 2 years of age or 2.5 years of age, we can diagnose. Like his speaking will be delayed, or he will be having irrelevant talk, talking towards and non-living items, means some dolly or something like that, talking towards the non-living items, and he will not sit in a place, he will be wandering here and there, and he will not having any social interaction and eye to eye contact. If you call him also, he will not look into our eyes. And even in the child, even before 2 years also, we can correlate with this. So all these things nowadays, even doctors also saying that meanwhile, while increasing the age, that will be getting better. But actually we have to differentiate what is disease, what is normalcy. So maximum 2.5 years of age we can detect with all these signs and symptoms. If any difficulty in diagnosing, just have a consultation with the doctor. My child is having these changes with compared to other child. Just have a consultation.
Is there any remedy or precaution to be take care?
Yes. Remedy and precaution. So first I will say about precautions. In the sense that has to be taken care of. Once we affect, and we will take remedy. Once we are not affecting with the disease, we are giving a hindrance to the causing of the disease. That is what we say, precautions. So whatever precautions that I say, the cause of the disease, just remove the cause. What will be the cause? In the sense, even the, we will say that garbhadana samskara in Ayurveda, we will say, in the sense, when to conceive, even before the conception, what are all the things to be taken care of? As I said, most of the time the conceiving is an accident nowadays. So without knowing they are conceiving, or without the knowledge of conceiving, they are getting or giving birth to a newborn. Actually, that is very harmful. We should have that view in our mind to get a good progeny in our mind. So even before the conception also, we have to take care of some food habits. In Ayurveda specifically said that some food habits will hinder the conception. Some food habits will enhance or withstand the conceived baby in the womb. So etc. things are told. You have to take care of all those things before conception. That is the first line of treatment or thing that we have to take precaution. The second thing, during pregnancy, what should be done? In the first month, what is there in my womb? Second month, what is going on in the womb? Third month, what is going on? So like that, we have to have a knowledge what is going on inside. It's like a painting. What's painting? During the artist, when he starts painting, we will see the picture, we will say that, oh, how ugly it is, how it will come. But after finishing the paint only, or painting, his real art comes out. So in between, some or other cosmic energy is preparing the child. So we don't want to interfere in that. Just leave it. We have to do some regimen and diet. So first thing, before conception, during conception, and afterwards also, after delivery, we have to take care of some things in the child as well as in the mother. So these regimen and diet will help almost, I feel, almost 80 to 85% we can cure or we can prevent this disease. Second thing is, not precaution, the other one, remedy. So remedy in the sense, we have to take care, as we should know that this disease will stay for lifelong for some children, and as early as possible you have to take action against, means to treat the disease. If a children or child is having hyperactivity, to decrease the hyperactivity or giving some anti sleeping pills or something like that is not the remedy. We should take care of what is going on inside, and the parents should accept that he is not a normal child. Normal in the sense, he is having extraordinary thinking, extraordinary power. We should say that what is the cause of the disease once more. Actually, in our mind, three qualities are there. In my mind, all the human beings are equipped with the three qualities. In Ayurveda, it says dhi, dhridi, and smriti. I'll translate it. What is dhi? Dhi in the sense, will have intelligence. We can say it as dhi. So our intelligent power is dhi. Second one is dhridi, that I will say. Third one is smriti. Smriti is nothing but memory power. So our two qualities are, one is intelligence and third one is memory. What is second one? That is dhridi. Dhridi in the sense, coordination. We can literally say that coordination. What should be done at what time? Actually, children with autistic or autism spectrum disorders are lacking in this area. They are lacking of this dhridi concept, that is coordination. They are having high intelligence power, high memory power, but they are lacking in the coordination. So we have to correct that defect. Whatever the dhridi concept is there in Ayurveda, we have to correct that. The link between intelligence and smriti or memory. The link between intelligence and memory is dhridi. So as the treatment or remedial measure, we have to treat this defect in the child. That is done only through brain regeneration, not degeneration. Usually sleeping pills, other things are doing literally of reducing the power of the nerves. We have to enhance the nervous system in the proper channel. Hyperactivity is nothing but energy level increase, and it is going through different channels. So you have to do regeneration with proper channelized way. That's the main remedial measure that should be done.
What's the treatment in Ayurveda? Any specific food habit want to be followed?
In Ayurveda, the first line of treatment is the defense of the cause. We should stop the cause. And in my hospital, Illam Ayurveda Hospital, since the hospital started more than, I think, probably more than 50 or 60 cases we have treated till now, mere autistic cases. And the fortunate or unfortunate thing, it has to be said that most of the autism sealed children, we can say that in other sciences, they will, even the slight derangement in the character also, they are saying that is autistic. That's not correct. And most of the autism cases, what we do in our hospital is a back to nature concept. Because I told, what is the defect? You have to find out the defect first. The dhridi concept, the coordination concept. They should know, if I bring the patient or the child nearby a rose plant, the children should know that it is having thorns. If it prick in my hand, that will pain. That is the coordination or dhruti concept. So for that, nature is the main thing. Only nature can help, and the whole treatment for autism, 50% of the treatment is done by nature. It's not like giving some medicines and stay in a concrete building and treating. So they should come out and they should be with the nature. They should see the birds, they should see the flower, they should see the thorns, they should see what is going to harm him, what is not harming him. So that should be done by the nature. That's the first thing. And the second thing, 25% is treatment. Whatever medicines, specialized medicines we are giving for treatment, even almost all Ayurveda treatments like Tala Podichil and Shirodhara, everything we are also doing with some special drugs, specially for this autistic children. And the other 25% is doing with the parents. That I used to say the parents that you should not say a single negative word against your child. Because usually I have seen almost 80 to 90 cases I have seen till now. Among that, almost 90% of parents are saying that only negative things about his or her children. Means in the home also, they should boost them. Even we know, if I say about you, how glory that you are having and how beautiful you are, how your mind will be. And if I say, oh, why, what happened, you are very ugly looking, what, why your skin are like blackish, you feel some narrow mind. This feeling is 100 times more in autistic children. So we should boost them. Anyway, these children are specially cared children, in the sense they are having special characters. Not like they are below some line. Actually, they are above our ability. So we have to find that ability. We have to boost the child. Then only that character will come up. That's why when I used to go to church also. In church, we will say that praise the Lord. What is praise the Lord? We have to praise the Lord so that quality will increase in our mind as well as those who are hearing also. So that praising itself is a line of treatment. So for autistic children, the treatment will be 50% of whatever the remedy or precaution to be taken care of. Nature is going to treat, medicines will going to treat, parents are treating, and the other things mainly are food habits. It's almost all cases, two of the cases I have let them discharged because of not seeing or not taking care of the food habits. You have to take care of the food habits. Mostly in Ayurveda we will say Rajasiga food. Means those food which are making them aggressive. Some food habits are there. So we have to avoid that food habits. Then only these children can be reversed. By God's grace, I can say that 4 or 5 children those are treated after 2-3 years. Anyway, yearly treatment is needed for almost 3 years. After 3 years, almost 4 to 5 cases, they have joined in normal school. It's not my miracle, but God's grace. Because all these things should come in a wrapper. Food, parents, treatment, God's grace. God's grace, I can say, it's a karma. In the sense, some parents are bringing their child at the age of 2.5 years. Some parents bring their children in the age of 10 years because they are hearing about this treatment center at the age of 10 only. So that parents or these parents are having that much karma to face till this 10 years. Some parents are bringing them in the age of 2.5 years. So they are having that karma to face all this because parents are affecting almost 90% than the children. So that parent has to face these many difficulties only 2.5 years. So time is important to get the treatment, to get good treatment.